Okay, thank you so much for the opportunity. Good afternoon, all of you. I'm Chayani Dilrukshi. I'm presenting my research findings on case studies on productivity improvement through work study. Actually, it's a literature review. This was some work that I have done when I was in Sri Lanka. So this work leads to some application in the later future. So let me start the presentation. Actually, this research problem targeted in this research was, are work study techniques effective in improving productivity of industries? That is actually, we know when talking about the productivity of industries, there are a lot of techniques that are coming into the forum, like total quality management, lean implementation, and like that. And also nowadays, the industrial engineering, as a part of that, work study techniques also come into play. So my research problem is targeting whether work study techniques are effective in improving the productivity industries. And I hope to do some literature survey on this. So the research objectives from this literature survey is to comprehend and understand the concept of work study in detail, and to identify the tools and techniques used in the industries, and to impact and to evaluate the impact on productivity improvement in the real world scenarios. That means I'm evaluating the case studies which have been done under this topic. So the real world scenarios are taken into place like that. And finally, I hope to understand and also to identify the challenges faced in implementation of work study techniques in these industries. So the methodology that I have followed during this literature survey is, like, I have surveyed through indexed and peer-reviewed journals and conference proceedings, books, and also some web resources. And I have identified more than like 10,000 plus research papers and also web articles based on this productivity as well as work study, because this is a hot topic in the industry. So like there were papers based on the concept and also the implementation and the relationship between the work study and productivity and also the work study challenges. And out of those them, and like I have selected some index journal papers of 25 papers, which were published from 2010 to 2020. So like as I was targeting the case study approach, like I selected 20 case studies and 5 concept papers as well to understand the concept of work study and productivity. And my major concern was on the case studies published. And finally, the benefits and the challenges of work studies were identified, and the conclusion was derived. So when I was evaluating the papers, the simple methodology that I found, I followed was like, I outlined the cases, like what is the journal and what was the journal publication year, and then what were the targeted industries, the basic outline, and then the methodology used by them. Like I will talk about the methodologies here later, and the tools and techniques used by those industries, and finally the outcomes they have achieved. So this was the classification of literature, the 25 papers which I used. So here you can see like the case studies which I have used. I have taken under 3 categories: the method study, the time study, and work study. I will tell later what these classifications is. Like these were the papers that I took into the consideration. So work study is my topic. And like, as I told you here, work study was one of the parts that I concerned in the case studies. So work study is basically the systematic examination of a job to improve for the effective use of resources and to set up standards of performance. So if I say simply what work study is, in the work study process, what happens in the industry is the work study department or as the work study personnel, they go through a rapid and also a systematic examination or is identification of the job process and the job, and then they find which what is the best way to do this job in the best time or is the within the standard amount of time. So within that two things, that means what is the best method to do that, and also what is the best timing or is what is the standard timing that we can do that. Based on that two scenarios, the work study can be divided into two parts, method study and time study. And what I like studied under this literature review is how this method study, time study, all together work study, how it impact on improving the productivity of the companies. So productivity is basically, we all know, that is the output divided by input, or is how much output is produced by the input in the organization. So as I told you, the work study is in two parts, method study and time study. So as I divided my literature as well, I found papers which have targeted, I mean the industries which have done their studies focusing on method study separately, and some studies were done focusing on time study separately, and some studies were done focusing on both. I mean, they have done method study and time study. That means the total work study approach. So if I first talk about the method study approach, the concept of method study before moving on to the literature. So method study is eliminating the unnecessary operations and achieving the best method of operations. So the method study process in brief is first step is like the work have to be selected, and then the operation and the job facts needs to be recorded, and then it should be examined, I mean the facts critically and in order of the sequence, and also the techniques should be examined, and a more practical and economic effective method should be developed, and finally that developed method should be defined and communicated in the factory, and it should be installed as a standard practice, and finally the maintenance, or else it should be controlled, or else it should be monitored regularly within the company whether it is taking place correctly. So that is the steps or else the process of method study. So the tools and techniques which I found from the literature basically it falls into two categories. There are the recording tools, there are charts of recording, and also there are diagrams. So the charts, if I take the charts, there are charts fall into two categories, macro motion charts and micro motion charts. Actually, all the literature which I have targeted was not taken all these tools and techniques. They have selected the techniques that they want. So the macro motion charts, process charts and multiple activity charts are some categories of macro motion charts. And the simultaneous motion charts, or as in the industry, we call them CMO charts. Those are micro motion charts, and the diagrams are flow diagrams and string diagrams, which are taken as tools in the method study. So if I say what these are, some two the photos to tell you what these process flow chart and multiple activity chart is. So you can see in the process flow charts, using some symbols, the process is simply identified, and the multiple activity chart, which is also given as the next figure. So as I told, I identified the cases based on method study separately, and the cases based on time study separately. So these were the cases based on method study. So those cases were taken from the industries which targeted those cases were fertilizer manufacturing companies, automobile, gear cutting, and some small scale manufacturing companies and apparel companies. We know that work study is a popular topic and a hot topic in the apparel industry, and water producing factories. So these were some six different industries which I studied this literature among literature about the method study. So we can see that different techniques were used by different studies, like preventive maintenance, process flow charts, and product multiple activity charts. They have used different techniques from method study, and they have achieved the outcome of improving productivity. And next topic is time study, the next part of work study. So time study is determining the standard time or as the best timing for doing a certain amount of a certain operation. So the steps of time study is given here. So the first, similar to the method study, we have to select the job and the operation to be timed. And then the details regarding the method, operator, job, and the working condition should be recorded. And then the elements, the breaking down of the jobs into parts, and the separate timing for those elements should be defined and recorded. And the time duration for each of those job elements should be measured separately using stopwatches or any other time measurement techniques. And finally, the observed time should be converted into normal time using an equation. I'll show you the equation. And then the relaxation and personal allowances should be determined. This relaxation and personal allowances are different from company to company. And finally, the standard time for that particular job should be computed. So this is the formulas to find the standard time. So first of all, as I told, like the job elements, observed time, we have to average that time and multiply it by the particular performance rating factor of the company or the industry and find the normal time. And then that normal time should be multiplied by 1 plus the allowance factor of that particular industry or the company to find the standard time. And these were the cases which I took on to study. Almost all of those cases were taken, these standard time calculations, as their tool and technique in the study. So those industries that I focus is, one was car seat manufacturing line, and an engine block manufacturing plant, and earth energy glass manufacturing and a battery manufacturing firm, and solar appliances manufacturing firm, an electrode manufacturing firm, and another one is also from the apparel industry. So almost all of these papers and these studies have been able to achieve an increased efficiency and increased productivity in their companies or in their particular industries by the use of time study. So these were the cases which I studied, which I've taken both method study and time study together into consideration and together applied and implemented in the company. So one was a rice-based company and another one apparel company, an assembly workstation and a small fiber composite company, and a leather product manufacturing company and a metal manufacturing company was among those case studies. So they have followed like a joint approach of method study and time study. So the tools and techniques consist of both time study tools and both time study and method study tools. So altogether, they also have been able to increase their productivity in the industries. So when I evaluated that case studies, so from those case studies, what I identified as the challenges when implementation of those work study techniques in that particular industries. I mean, these are some common challenges that I took from reading those cases. One was the introduction, the introduction of these work study techniques change the working culture of that particular company or as the particular industry. So, you know, change is not an easy target when it comes to business management forums or as business management companies or organizations. So because most of the people and most of the companies are reluctant to change. So this is challenge when implementation of work study in the company, and the lack of commitment from senior and middle management, because like when implementation of such a new technique in the company, a commitment from all the levels of management and all the employees from the entire organization is needed. And if the next challenge is the poor understanding of concepts. Although this concept has been evolved from a certain amount of time, there are still some companies which do not have a better knowledge of these concepts and the theoretical and also the application side of these concepts. So the poor understanding of concepts is also a challenge. And the employees' attitudes that means like they may think like, okay, when the introduction of this, they may lose their jobs and they may lose their salaries. There can be some certain challenging attitudes from the employee sides, and there should be an high initial in there should be an investment in the initially. So that can be somewhat a challenge for the companies. And if the workforce is not so skilled sometimes in the company, that can also be a challenge to that particular company. So in conclusion, what I did was like, I hope to go through some literature, which is which is about work study and the improving of productivity from work study. So from these, analyzing these case studies, I identified that productivity can be improved by redesigning of process layouts and enhancing the product quality and reducing the process and waiting time, cycle time and machine downtime from the time study, and also by reducing the workers' fatigue. I mean, like the method study and time study were focusing on achieving of these targets. So so that was like what I studied, or is what I found from this study. And actually, as I told in the beginning, like this study is a foundation for some future research that I'm hoping to do with the Japanese context. So that means I would like to, like, as I figured out from these researchers, like most of the researchers were done in the Asian, I mean the South Asian, or as Indian, Sri Lankan, Bangladeshi, Pakistan, those contexts. So this has not been so much, I mean, the research work has not been so much identified in countries like the Western countries. So because of that, I would like to apply and see whether the same results are applicable to some Japanese firm as well. So that's it. Thank you very much for listening.
Thank you very much, Ms. Shayani, for your presentation. And I have a small suggestion for your future studies. I think you also mentioned that you are going to apply, or you are going to research this work study techniques in Japanese context. Not only Japanese context, but also if you can study about Western world also, then it's the results quite might be reasonable then, isn't it? Right.
Yes.
You can improve some. There may be having different scenarios under those developed countries, but then and also you can compare with different countries, like non-developed countries, developing countries, and developed countries. So then you can understand the question very well. Okay, thank you very much, Ms. Saini, again for your
presentation. Thank you very much for your suggestions as well.
Yeah, yes.